India signs UNISA, experts call for local laws supporting treaty. The United Nations Convention on International Settlement Agreements, UNISA, was signed by India's High Commissioner to Singapore Jawed Ashraf, representing the Government of India. Kashmir issue, Pakistan expels Indian envoy, suspends bilateral trade. Islamabad has also decided to review bilateral arrangements with New Delhi and to take the Kashmir issue to the UN. Security Council. Grill brings Tiffany to India, plans to open stores in Delhi and Mumbai. Bengaluru, Reuters, India's Reliance Industries Ltd is partnering with iconic U.S.-based luxury jeweler Tiffany & Co. to open a line of stores in the country, adding yet another marquee name to its growing portfolio of brands. RBI lowers repo rate by 35 basis points to 5.40%. All six members of the Monetary Policy Committee voted in favor of the rate cut. Transfer funds 24x7 via NEFT from December. Come December, you can transfer funds round the clock using the National Electronic Funds Transfer or NEFT facility. RBI Governor Shaktikanta Das announced. RBI brings in Central Fraud Registry, a likely major game changer for banking. The participants in RBI's payment system will be given access to this registry for fraud monitoring that is likely to be almost real-time. Pakistan's counter-terrorism department declares Hafiz Saeed guilty of terror financing. ACTD official told PTI that it submitted Holland in the ATC declaring Hafiz Saeed guilty of terror financing. Oyo appoints Mandar Vaidya as CEO for Southeast Asia and Middle East. Hospitality firm Oyo Hotels & Homes on Wednesday said it has appointed Mandar Vaidya as the Chief Executive Officer for Southeast Asia and the Middle East, effective from August 1, 2019. The appointment comes as part of company's ongoing focus to drive accelerated growth in two of its high-potential markets, Southeast Asia and the Middle East, Oyo said in a statement. Vaidya has over 15 years of experience. He would be responsible for driving business growth for Oyo in these two regions, which include markets like Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, Vietnam, UAE, and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, it added. We are thrilled to welcome Mandar to the Oyo family as he takes charge of strengthening Oyo's presence in Southeast Asia and the Middle East, Oyo Hotels & Homes founder and CEO Raich Agarwal said. These two markets are crucial for Oyo's international expansion strategy, he added. Thank you for watching. Download all weekly, monthly, and yearly current affairs PDFs curated by Exam Bazaar experts to boost your preparation.